Let's just get into the news. Now, first news, EFCC reportedly asked Mastercard and Visa Incorporated for Naira Marley's card transaction history. According to reports, EFCC wrote Mastercard and Visa a few days ago after the music star was arrested. And it was believed that the cards recovered from Naira Marley were used for identity theft and credit card fraud. The commission in its letter to Visa reportedly asked the company to provide information about the last five transactions on each of three Visa cards recovered from Naira Marley. In its letter to Mastercard, the EFCC asked the company to produce information about the last five transactions on a Mastercard recovered from Naira Marley too. You'll remember that the EFCC filed 11 charges against the Isago singer following his arrest last month, and of course we reported that he was granted a 2 million bail last week. So we're talking about Naira Marley, brand new month. Naira Marley is still in jail, and now EFCC, they are going in.
But then it was reported that he was also released on the bail conditions.
From what we heard.
Okay.
So I think I don't think the 2 million naira is the problem. I think it's the surety.
Yeah.
So
landed property around Ikoyi.
I mean, with this kind of mess, I don't think someone, a civil servant, would want to put their name on the line. I'm not sure, but I hope that he gets someone and then he gets out.
So the fact whereby EFCC is now going in, requesting Mastercard and Visa to bring out,
I think that's a very good move. Actually,
it's a good move
for everybody, actually, and not just for Naira Marley. I like the fact that because identity threat, fraud is a big issue that people have been facing, and most times it just ends at it happened to you, okay. So at least I'm happy to hear that you can actually do something about it instead of just blocking your
card. And I think that, you know, the case is still going to be in court October 22nd, 23rd, and 24th.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they will need people to come up with their evidences and all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. So.
Somebody was saying Mastercard and Visa would never do something like that.
Why?
What? I don't know.
No, they'll have to. If not, they'll be blocking justice, or what they call those things. Oh. There's a thing for it, actually. They have to. All right. So moving on to our next story. Now, U.S. police questions Chris Atta about late wife's death. Now, reports have it that Chris Atta's tweet following his late wife, Betty Jennifer's death, has led him to being interviewed for questioning by the U.S. police as part of the ongoing investigation. Now, a Greenbelt police spokesman, George Matthews, said that some cryptic tweets the Ghanaian actor shared about relationship and loyalty some hours before Betty was murdered and all are all being considered in the ongoing investigation. Now, in his first post following Betty Jennifer's murder, Chris Atta tweeted, "When it comes to relationships, remaining faithful is never an option, but a priority. Now, loyalty is ever ..." Now, you might remember that shortly after Betty Jennifer's death a few weeks ago, it was revealed that she was married to a convicted drug pusher, Kedrick, and she was said to be in the process of a divorce from Kedrick when she was murdered. Now, she got married to Chris Atta in October last year, hence apparently legally married to two men at the time of her death. Yes, we did hear, we were following this story also last month, and, you know, finding out that, first of all, he deleted all her pictures, and everybody was wondering what was going on. And the next thing that she was dead, and next thing we heard that she was connected to a drug pusher, and then his tweets, it's not really very helpful in this situation, but like
they also said the description of the person in the video,
from what they drew the sketch,
that's why it became a prime suspect. So it was following the sketch, and then they went to check, and then they found that he tweeted something about that, and a few weeks before then he had taken our pictures as well. So I'm just worried, and I'm just scared, and I just hope that he has nothing to do with it, because it would be really bad. Like, I mean, maybe she was unfaithful or whatever, but going down that lane,
she never go to that level. But then again, these are all just, they're still gathering the evidence. They're still speculations,
so we have to wait. Alleged keyword. Thank you. All right, guys, moving on in the foreign news. Embattled singer R. Kelly has been slammed with new 11-count charges and for abuse and sexual assault. Now, according to reports, the Cook County State Attorney's Office recently filed the following charges on R. Kelly's. Now, this is 5 counts of aggravated criminal sexual abuse, 4 counts of aggravated criminal sexual assault, and 2 counts of criminal sexual assault. Now, according to the documents released, R. Kelly is being accused of forceful relations with his victims back in 2010. Now, the alleged victim is said to have been 18 as at the time of the incident, and so were the 3 other alleged victims, who were between 13 and 16. Now, the singer will, reportedly be back in court next week to be arraigned on the new charges. Earlier in the year, if you remember, R. Kelly was charged with a separate 10 counts of aggravated criminal sexual abuse. I saw this thing this morning, and I was just like,
I don't even know what to say because, but at the same time, I feel like the whole world is happy about this development.
Yeah.
Most people who were saying,
his real fans are not.
I'm a real fan.
I'm a real fan as well. So yeah, here is the thing. If they find out that the charges are real, then it's a good thing that you're saying that even though you're a very well-known public figure, you're a big musician, you cannot go away without...
You're not
above the law, exactly. So, yeah, on the flip side, but on the other side of it, it's going to be really sad if R. Kelly goes to jail,
We're still keeping our fingers crossed regarding the story because it keeps coming every time and more charges are still coming
More
up.
Charges, like the 10 is there. Separate from this 11. That's the thing.
I think one lesson we have to learn from this is you can't run away from the past. You know how most times it's like, I'm turning a new leaf, I'm leaving everything behind. You have to be really careful in your 20s because some mistakes you make, maybe when OJ is now 65.
Well, you're turning a new leaf, I think that you should address some things that you've done in the past.
Yeah.
If you need to apologize to people, apologize to them. If you need to... just do what you have to do moving forward. Because if he had done that, I don't think they'll come for
exactly.
him. Because I think the reason why they came out to do this and then they came out with the documentary was because he probably felt like, I'm above the law. Nothing is going to happen to me. Mm-hmm. I'm R. Kelly. Like, what are you guys talking about?
Okay, I'm going to throw in the race card. Maybe because he's black?
No, it has nothing to do with that. Thank you.
Okay.
Moving on, and finally, Kim Kardashian helps free 17 prisoners in 90 days. Look like reality star Kim Kardashian has been investing her money and time in some good deeds. According to TMZ, the mother of three has been working to help secure the release of these inmates who have been doing time in jail. And as we recently reported, she has been working in conjunction with her lawyer, Brittany K. Barnett, as well as other lawyers to make this happen. These lawyers have, in the last few months, done the legal groundwork while Kim has been footing all the bills. However, it has been reported that Kim has been getting all these inmates free while trying to keep it away from the media. Kim has been really proving that she's neck deep into her newfound love for criminal justice. Matthew Charles was recently released from jail after serving 25 years and will be living in a rent-free house for the next 5 years, courtesy Kim Kardashian.
I actually love what she's doing. 17 inmates released. It's no joke. I mean, go Kim.
It's good that to change your calling.
Can I?
Yeah. What do you want to say? Say.
You know how? I don't know. This is just my own opinion.
Yeah.
I am entitled to my opinion.
It's a joke.
Just saying before they come for me. I feel that we were talking about Kylie and Kim.
Oh yeah.
Competing.
Kinda. I'm just saying kinda. Mm-hmm. So you know how Kylie's now putting all her stuff into makeup, skin and stuff. Mm-hmm. And then she's doing about the same thing. She just feels like, let me do something
extra.
Different. Let me do something, to stand out.
So in this case, I'll usually agree with you, but in this case, I think that is different. Now, because Kim is older, Kim is actually the one who started off this Kardashian
thing.
We're not talking about how she started it, OJ. We're talking about the fact that it's her story that revolved into Kylie and all of this. So Kylie is much younger and her storyline is much different. She didn't really start from the bottom. Now we're here. She was already at the top when she started. Now, Kim has a story. She had a better relationship with her father, who was a lawyer as well. So I think that rubbed off on them. Exactly.
And changing the narrative.
Yeah. Akru, I hear you guys.
What?
Akru, I hear you.
No, honey, it's
She's
not Akru.
Changing the narrative.
Akru, I hear you.
Okay, from that, up next, ladies and gentlemen, is a wrap on the news.
All right, guys, moving on. This is Tribute, where we bring you all the savagery, humor, and craziness social media has to offer in 5 minutes or less. How about still today? Moving on. Oh my goodness. So, LOC understands Dev Junaid tweeted this thing. He says, Nigerians are so effing rude. How can you bring a live chicken in a black nylon to someone's house as a gift by 6 a.m. and not tell the person that it's a freaking live chicken? Like, I was busy hugging the nylon and the next thing, nylon was running away from me. Running nylon?
I was like, oh, thank you, babe.
This would be scary. AF.
If you do this to my mother,
honestly speaking,
if you do this to my mother, she's going to report it to our pastor. She's going to bind and cast you.
Did you see that one of the
bats? 6 a.m. they're bringing black nylon chicken inside black nylon. 6 a.m. my woman will look for the spiritual meaning to it and everything. And all of us in the house will suffer because we'll do VG. I will do deliverance.
Arike, did you see that bat on Instagram?
Which bat? That's why it was burning bats.
A bat flew into someone's house. The guy bounced it and said, blood of Jesus. That's what will happen with this.
I don't like bats. Moving on, church is the best place to go after a breakup. You'll be in the crowd crying hard and everyone will think you're in the spirit. Look, guys, our daily top five was talking to you guys about how to leave after a breakup. So I think this is like number six on the list. This is number six on the list. And trust me, I can relate.
What?
I can relate.
You can relate?
What from experience. That day.
People think you're
You know that is when they dump you that you remember that God love you.
Okay.
So I go church. Let me speak properly. I went to church. And then the thing I was crying about was not the song, but my so there's this Christian song that boy used to listen to a lot. And that was the song that they used to lead the word. So I was crying. They even took my picture and posted it. They said,
Sister Rika in the spirit.
Worship something when it activated. Breaks your soul, when it this thing. I liked it. I put heart and prayer because I'm like, heart is for love, then prayer.
God forgive you. Wow.
People
will not know you are crying. And if you go to people like Amanda and you are crying after a breakup, I'm like, why are you crying? Have you seen yourself? Those people that used to make you not cry.
Chimamanda then. Yeah.
Chimamanda.
Wow.
Go to church and pray. I'm crying. Oh my goodness. Which of this Gary would you know? Which Gary do you like soaking, yellow or white? First of all, before I even read the response, the person that tweeted this thing, why is that saying I don't know there? Because I need to find that person. For you to think that you can soak yellow Gary,
it's not nice.
I don't know where you're from, but this is your response. Anybody that soaks yellow Gary is a cultist. It's not just a cultist, it's a demon. No, there's demon.
It's not that deep.
There's demon.
Some people don't like the sour taste of the Jebu Gary. It's too for them. Yeah.
Do you know that, first of all, have you tried to make a bar with this yellow Gary? When you first put it in the water, there's a way it used to, first of all, add Iberaga, like pride. It's not one to calm down. Then it's not by force. You now put more water to turn it. How do you want to drink it? The thing, I used to have cocoa.
Yellow Gary.
Yes. Actually, it's very big like this.
The cocoa is like OJ's hair.
Wow. Wow, on that note.
Nice one. Continue with your distance.
OJ is still giving me shit.
He's not going to give you. It's not. But just continue. Just rub it.
Please, next tweet. People have left me abuse OJ. Now, and I didn't mean to. OJ, I'm sorry. Bye. All right, moving on. Naming a Drogon is the laziest thing. I decided to make it easy. Most lazy thing I've ever heard. LMAO, Lamao. Please, meet my dog, Deg.
Honestly speaking, now you talk. Defend your Game of Thrones
people like
OJ. I don't understand that thing. Because I always want...
There were three dragons.
Called Drogon.
Oh, is it from Game of Thrones?
I was from Game of Thrones.
I don't succumb to peer pressure. So I didn't watch it.
This is like the most popular dragon. So it's just nice that they had to name it.
So they changed
the
zero to...
That was lack of creativity.
Name your dragon. Name your dog Deg now.
Yeah,
guys, if we were in a Nollywood movie... If we were in a Nollywood movie and they named the dog Deg, they will come for us. But now because it's the almighty Game of Thrones, please hold it.
Because there's no creativity in Nollywood.
Well, she has a point. She does have a point. And I've seen Game of Thrones made in Nollywood. Have you seen it?
God.
Did you see it?
There.
Yes, they have a dragon. It was moving.
You see your people now.
Moving on. This is my moment. You guys are not going to. This is my moment. Moving on. Do not talk to them. Focus on just me. Next tweet, please. Twitter, check on your friends. Okay, check on your friends often. They may be feeling low. We all know all that stuff. Me, hey bro, how are you? Friend, Baba, as I day like this, I don't want. Make I call you later, beg. OJ.
They may be feeling low.
But
I'm
they're
high. Oh my God, this song.
Do you get? So.
But wow.
However, I still check up on them.
Yes, still do.
Because that highness can lead to another kind of level.
There might be a reason why they're getting high. So do check up on them.
So, in as much as OJ.
Baba, they're all right. I don't
want to. That's
me. I will call you later.
I still check up on him. I think that's all we have for you guys on Tribal today. So, that's
thank
all
you, Arike. On this note, it's a wrap on the first half of the show. Yo.